It's on. हाँ वन सेकेंड, आई जस्ट शेयर द स्क्रीन.
हरे कृष्णा प्रभु.
हरे कृष्णा जगन्नाथ तीर्थ प्रभु. सो वेर आर वी नाउ?
घंटोली
जय घंटोली धाम की, ब्रजमंडल परिक्रमा की
जय.
Vrindavan is a place where you'll get like lassis and rabdis. Hope all of you enjoyed lassi and rabdi. Varsana. So today, Brajamandal Parikrama ki.
Jai.
I'm not able to hear online.
Jai.
Jai. Oh, at least Jagannath Prabhu is awake. So today we're going to go to the most auspicious place in the whole universe, that is Radha Kunda. So before we go there, yesterday Sadanand Prabhu took us to Ghantoli Dham, and this is the amazing DT, Gopal Ji DT, and Prabhu was explaining the amazing verse which explains about the smiling face of the Lord. And the result is, when we see this smiling face of the Lord and the eyebrows, so we have always attraction towards material thing or opposite sex. So that is diminished just by seeing the beautiful eyebrow of Supreme Lord. And we'll go further. Before we start, let us offer our prayers to Srila Prabhupada. नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्ण प्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमदे भक्ति वेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिनी नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा राम रामा हरे हरे. Let's wrap up what we have gone through in this Brajamandal Parikrama. So first day we started with Vrindavana, Krishna Balram Temple. And then we proceeded towards Akrura Ghat. And from there, we proceeded towards Mathura Dham, the birthplace of Lord Krishna. And from there, we went to Madhuvan, Talvan, and then we proceeded towards Titagram. And from there, we went to Ghantoli. And today, we're going to go to Radha Kund. Radha Kund ki! Hi. So, I just want you all to see this picture and... Can all of you tell me where are we now? Online.
Prabhu, we are inside, Prabhu, where Radha and Krishna are residing.
That's one way Brajamandal Parikrama is right. But we are in this material world. You can see that this is called Paravyoma, and we are in this material world. And this material world, you can see this Devi. I am moving my cursor. You can see this. So she's always praising us with her trident, with three types of miseries: Adhyatmik, Adidevi, Adibhautik. So misery is because of our own mind and body. Misery is because of other living entities, Adibhautik. And misery is because of our because of higher planetary system or higher arrangements like Daivik, Adi Daivik, or because of like example maybe famine or heavy rain, or it's there's cold weather and all. So that is because of nature, Mother Nature. So we are always beaten up by these three types of miseries. And this material world, there's always four type of miseries: Janma, Mrityu, Jara, Vyadi. And we cannot escape. It's very tough, because this Durga, Mother Durga, she's always poking us with her trident. Why she's poking us with her trident? Because we are averse of Krishna. We don't want to take Krishna, or we don't want to take devotional service very seriously. And that's the reason the Maya is beating us like anything. And we'll go a little further. And Prabhupada explains that this material world is 25% of this whole universe or whole creation. And the spiritual world is of 75%. So 3/4 is the spiritual world and 1/4 is this material world. And it is compared to a prison house. Just like in city, there's a prison house where rebellious souls or rebellious citizens are kept in that prison house, so that they don't create disturbance to the normal people. So that's the system. We'll go further. There's an amazing verse which describes about this Radha Kunda. And this verse says like this: Vaikunta Janito Vara Madhupure Tatrapi Rasotsavat Vrindaranyam Udarapani Ramanat Tatrapi Govardhana Radha Kundam Hiyapi Gokula Pate Premamruta Plavanat Kuryad Asya Virajito Giritate Sevan Viveki Nakahi. So the verse begins like this: Vaikunta Janito Vara Madhupure. So this Madhupure is Mathura. The holy place known as Mathura is spiritually superior to Vaikunta. So the word Vaikunta means the place where there is no anxiety. The opposite of this place is full of anxiety. This material world is full of anxiety. The day we begin our day, it starts with anxiety, full of anxiety. What I should do? What I should do further? How do I begin my day? Where to put money? Where not to put money? Many things. And there is a cost or there is a problem oriented to our any activities. Maybe good or maybe bad. So it is describing the Vaikunta, the planet Vaikunta is a spiritual world, is a transcendental world. Above that is the Mathurapuri, the place where Lord Krishna appeared. And higher than that is, superior to Mathurapuri, is the transcendental forest of Vrindavana because of Krishna's Rasalila pastime. Vrindaranyam Udarapani Ramanat Tatrapi Govardhana. Here, Udarapani refers to Lord Krishna. Ramanath refers to pastimes, various pastimes which Lord Krishna performed in the foothills of Govardhana Hill. And furthermore, Radha Kundam Hiyapi Gokula Pathe Premamruta Plavanath. So it explains that superior to the forest of Vrindavana is Govardhana Hill, for it was raised by the divine hand of Sri Krishna and was a site of various pastimes. And this verse, there is amazing things what Rupa Goswami has clearly defined. Like he is giving the conclusion that who is that intelligent person who will not take shelter of this Radha Kunda. I'll just move this. The holy place known as Mathura is spiritually superior to Vaikunta, the transcendental world, because the Lord appeared there. Superior to Mathura Puri is the transcendental forest of Vrindavana because of Krishna's Rasalila pastimes. And superior to the forest of Vrindavana is Govardhana Hill, for it was raised by the divine hand of Sri Krishna and was a site of his various loving pastimes. And above all, the super excellent Sri Radha Kunda stands supreme, for it is overflooded with the ambrosial nectarian prema of the Lord of Gokula, Sri Krishna. Where then is that intelligent person who is unwilling to serve this divine Radha Kunda, which is situated at the foothill foot of Govardhana hill. So this verse clearly defines about the superiority of Radha Kunda. The topmost place in the whole universe is Radha Kunda. So we'll go further. Even Lord Chaitanya, when he came to Vrindavana, Lord Chaitanya appeared 500 years ago. He was not different from Krishna. He was Krishna himself. And he was just searching out in Vrindavan, where is Radha Kund, where is Radha Kund? So it is said in this Chaitanya Charitamrita. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhya Lila, it is stated that when Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu first visited the area of Brajabhumi, he could not at first find the location of Radha Kunda. This means that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was actually searching for the exact location of Radha Kunda. Finally, he found the holy spot, and there was a small pond. Now you'll see that there is a big pond. It's very big. Those time it was 3 by 3 feet. It was that small. He took his bath in that small pond and told his devotees that the actual Radha Kund was situated there. Later, the pond was excavated by Lord Chaitanya's devotees, headed first by the 6 Goswamis such as Rupa and Raghunath Das. Presently, there is a large lake known as Radha Kunda there. Srila Rupa Goswami has given much stress to Radha Kunda because Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's desire to find it. Who then could give up Radha Kunda and try to reside elsewhere? No person with transcendental intelligence could do so. The importance of Radha Kunda, however, cannot be realized by other Vaishnava Sampradaya. So the Radha Kunda is known only to Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya. The other Sampradayas, they even do not know. It's like Prabhupada has given the treasure house. It's like a confidential knowledge is revealed because of the blessings of Prabhupada and the previous acharyas like Guru. Nor can person uni interested in the devotional service of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu understand the spiritual importance and divine nature of Radha Kunda. Thus, Radha Kunda is mainly worshipped by the Gaudiya Vaishnavas, the followers of Lord Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So we'll go further. I'll just show you the video of how Radha Kunda appeared.
I started Daily Harvest because I wanted to create food without compromises. That means real, nourishing.
Sweets to fill a demon's belly. I need to lay down.
And I need more. Brother, today you have surely added to your list of great miracles.
You mean added to his list of sins, don't you? Now the pious and righteous Krishna has killed a bull as well.
He was not a bull, but a terrible demon, disguised as a bull.
Oh, Krishna, that may be true. Still, he was a male cow, and you must atone for your sin.
Very well. I shall bathe in the Yamuna tomorrow.
Ha! That's not enough.
Lalita is right. To atone for such a grave sin, you must purify yourself by bathing in every holy river in the world.
I've got a great idea. Why wander throughout the world when I can bring all the holy rivers here and take my bath in them?
Oh, Krishna, stop dreaming.
Am I? Just watch.
Connected with the Vedas, saints, and Lord Vishnu. I am Narmada, and I have come from the body of Lord Shiva.
And I am your favorite, Yamuna, daughter of Surya, the sun god. I will be cleansed simply by your touch. Please, enter my waters.
It will be my pleasure. This pond shall be called Shyama Kund. Its holy waters are so refreshing. Now I have become pure from bathing in my Shyama Kund. But you three have become contaminated from siding with the demon, Arishtasura. Come, bathe away your sins in my pond.
No, the water in your pond is soiled by your sin. We shall make our own pond.
Yes, right here, where Arishtasura dug his hoof into the earth.
Waiting for the rain, I'm sorry to report. There isn't a cloud in the sky.
Are you sure you won't accept some of my contaminated water?
No, thank you. We'll bring pure water from the Mansi Ganga.
Do you think they could use my help, Balaram?
Surely no one else could. Fill their needs, dear brother.
Oh, it's no use. It will take a lifetime to fill this pond.
Oh, Radha, I see you're fatigued and distraught. please accept our service and allow us to fill your pond with our holy waters.
Yes, thank you. There is no other way.
I shall come and bathe here every day.
Your pond is also very beautiful, Krishna. I shall bathe and play with my friends here every day.
So we saw how Radhakund was appeared. So it is said when Radharani accepts a deity, Radharani wants to give shelter to anyone. He may be foolish. Krishna will accept at whatever condition. So now I want you all to just sit erect and take a deep breath. And this. Now we're going to enter the area of Radhakunda. Just calm. Take one more deep breath. And this is the most auspicious place in the whole universe. And we're going to sit near this step. Before entering there, I want everyone to offer obeisances to Radhakunda. Once the obeisances is done, we're going to do a sankalpa or a pushpanjali for Radhakunda. So I'm going to chant some mantras. You can just I'll tell you when to chant your gotra and nakshatra and name. So I'm going to chant that mantra. Yashyam Shubhato Shri Bhagavat Agnyaha Bhagavat Kinkarya Rupam Shishi Radha Krishna Pirti Asam Asya Jaman Asya. Now everyone can chant their gotras by mute. Saparivas. Then everyone can chant their name. All their relatives' name and whatever names. Now, Saparivas Kutumbasya Shema Stairya Vijaya Virya Arogya Aishwarya Abhiradam Sarvadosha Nivaratam Shishi Radha Krishna Bhakti Praptam. So now it's like in mind we are offering Pushpanjali to Radhakunda. So whatever flowers you have, just pour it towards the Radhakunda. So Mansi, offering of flower is done. So now we can enter into the Radhakund Mansik way and holding our hand towards the chain because it's very deep water and we have to be careful. We should not play like ordinary swimming pool what we play, like jump here and there. No, just we have to take 3 dips. 1, 2, 3. And then come out. And further tomorrow we'll have our special pariknama. We'll go towards the Govardhana hill. It's the most auspicious place where Lord Krishna lifted it for 7 continuous days. So Radha Kund ki, Govardhan ki, Shila Prabhupada ki. Hare Krishna. Now we're going to continue Damodar Astaka and I'll stop here.